doctors. Let's give an applause to our chief guest to present his lecture on psychological update. Now the session starts.
Good morning, everybody. Sir, I think I will clarify the position if I let you know how I have grown from the beginning, and you will be able to understand me, and you will be able to understand my thought process. Thereby, you will be able to clarify your own doubts. And with each session, in the end of the session, kindly send me the slips, your doubts and all that. I will clarify everything. You ask me any question, I don't hesitate to answer. If I can't answer, I will run back to Yellur and read. Because there are only two people who do not have doubts or do not have who knows everything. That is, one is God, and the fellow is another fool who doesn't know anything. If you think, if we people, yourself and myself, are, we feel in between these two, we will have doubts, we will have our deficiencies in knowledge and all that. Let us fill up the gaps by understanding each other and having attraction. Interaction. Then people have asked me that let us have a symposium. Don't put it as a symposium, let me put it as a workshop, with the intention that we must have an interaction of the mind and understand the thing. Otherwise, there is no point in you people coming from deep south and spending so much of money, and myself coming from Elur and spending 2 days together. Let us, as per this Kathopanishad says, that in the Santi Mantra, let us not hate each other. Let us work together, let us learn together, let us elevate in our knowledge in both the ways. Because you may put a question which may draw my attention to a point which I never thought of in my lifetime. That will instigate me to read in that direction. That does not mean that you are neither I am a fool nor you are a fool. But let us learn it in that way. That is why the great Kathopanishad said like that one. Now let us start with the subject. Put on the first switch. And put a paper on that. Sir, I don't know. I hope you know me. My previous history. I am an MSCND. Suddenly I thought of reading homeopathy. And I went around many people, nobody has taught me, neither the allopaths or homeopaths, whoever is in conversant with homeopathy. So I started reading the homeopathy on my own accord, and my repertory work started with Bogar Bonihasan repertory, because there is a small book called How to Find a Similimum in Bogar Bonihasan repertory. And with that I have worked out some 75 exercises what he has given. And for 2 years, I have been living only with Bogar Bonihasan repertory without touching the mental symptoms at all. Believe me a point. So, I never used to probe the mind at all. Only in physical generals and modalities and all that I used to prescribe. And I was using, getting reasonably good results. And Dr. Ramesh, who was an assistant professor of, in Gudada Medical College, he came and learned Bonihasan from me. And at that time, he did one case. One engineer went into an acute psychotic state due to some situations. And he was saying that Dr. Channa Reddy left the whole state to me without giving me much power, this and that. And when Channa Reddy went to America, and he was taken to psychiatrist, and they gave him some antipsychotic drugs, and nothing happened. They wanted to give an ECT and all that. In the meantime, the patient was brought to Dr. Ramesh. Taking on the physical symptoms alone, and only arsenic and naxvomica is coming out, he was not able to decide. And on the pattern of the distribution of sweat, he has decided on naxvomica. And he gave naxvomica 0/1. In 4 days, the patient was normal. That means he has done almost reverse of Kent. Kent used to say that you can treat the diseases by doing the mental symptoms. Dr. Ramesh has done with physical symptoms that he has treated a mental disease. At that time, when the case was presented to me, I was also jumping with pleasure, because the mind is like your hand. One side is mind and the other side is physical general. If you do it correctly, either this way or this way, you can come to the reasonable way of, you can come to the simulum. But the thing is, just like the people say, there are many a slip between a cup and a lip. The patient may not say the symptom. Patient has to understand what he is and what is the trouble he is having. He must tell us. We must be able to convert his symptom into rubric and then repertorize it and all those things. And so many problems, sometimes we are missing the cases. And the next case, next point. Then that is the difficulty with psychosomatic disorders. In the psychosomatic disorders, sometimes you find patient has come to you with a peptic ulcer. Absolutely, that pain in the abdomen after eating, some flimsy modalities will be there, and the patient aggravated by sour food, which is normal to disease. You will find only the disease symptoms, nothing more. And you cannot treat that case. Then I started thinking, I am deficient in studying the thing. The cause for this, the peptic ulcer is in the mind. Unless you probe the mind and analyze the mind, you can't treat this peptic ulcer. Otherwise, we are just giving some medicine, some natrum pass or anything, just like an allopathic man giving the MPS and all that, Gelusil MPS or some famotidine and all that. There is no difference between them and us. So then that has started. I started reading, I must read these mental symptoms. Then the first thing that when I started reading mental symptoms, the first point that has come to me is, what is the difference? What is feeling? What is emotions? These are all the basic doubts you will get. And you please remember, I have not come with any new theory, my interpretation, this and that. I just came to tell you how far I have understood that five masters at the beginning, that Hanuman Boninghasan, Bogar and Herring and Bogar, of course the Kent in the middle. That's all. I limit myself to the study of these five people. That is more than sufficient for any homeopathic case to prepare. You need not run after the modern people who goes on interpreting things and bringing their own theories and all that. Is all confusing. We forget about it. At least I don't do it. Now, the first word, that's why I am saying I am rock bottom fundamental points I am teaching now. These things, there is no question of interpretation. Here, the feeling means an image, a thought, an idea that comes into the mind. But whereas an emotion is, literal meaning of the emotion is to move. That means one teacher one day is teaching emotion means to move. So emotion makes you move. Then I was teaching that it is the feeling which produces a physiological change in the body that is called emotion. So he was having trouble and I was having a trouble. Then in the end of the lecture I clarified, sir, feelings, these emotions means a physiological change coming along with the idea or with a feeling preparing you to move. Either run away or fight or kiss or do anything. So that emotion, that is the arousal of this nervous system and producing the thing. So from there I have started, and I had to face a lot of trouble, and I will describe how the troubles have come to me so that you will not come into the same trouble, you will not be faced into the same trouble. Next point. Then... Experience, then once I decided Once I decided to study this the mental symptoms, first of all I went to the homeopath. They said, we don't know, we can't teach you. Then I went to the psychologist. Then he said, it is nothing. I say, we are only bothered about your anxiety scale, depression scale, then all these scales, but we don't know what is your rubric, your symptoms and all that. Then I went to a psychiatrist. Then psychiatrist, with a big recommendation letter from two people, sir, I want some books I want to read and I want to learn about the mental symptoms and all that. Then he called his assistant, he take him to the library and explain what he wants, he just give you the material and all that. And the library, I was searching the books, the assistant came and said, what is it, doctor, what is it you want? So, sir, in our homeopathic meter, in the repertory, there are 6-7 symptoms are there on sexual field. MA2-ness, amorousness, lewdness, lasciviousness, and then satyriasis, nymphomania, increased sexual desire, all these things. I want the differentiation between these 7 points. This is that purpose I wanted to have a book and all that. Then he said, you come along with me. And he took me to the superintendent of the hospital and he said, sir, this man is talking something which you can't understand. So literally I ran away from that psychiatrist hospital. If I am there for another half an hour, they may put me inside. Actually, this has happened in Madras, in Hyderabad psychiatric hospital. Then I was terribly frustrated. What to do? And then there was a linguistics meeting. The English language people, there was a meeting. I went there. I hosted a tiffin for a morning time tiffin with my caste, and I inquired, sir, what is the difference between these 7 words? There are rubrics. And he said, Are, what is it? Why are you suffering? They are all synonyms. I say nothing there. Over. I was scratching my head. What to do this thing? How to understand this thing? Then what has happened? Then I caught hold of a friend who has read psychology a lot, and he gave me books, the Freudian psychology, ego, super ego, then your id and all that, plenty of psychic mechanisms dumped with explanations how the mind works, how this and that. But reading of all those things, how to select the middle medica, how to select the symptom, how to select the drug taking the mental symptom, that is my worry. Then I pushed off that pride and caught hold of Adler. Adler's psychology, that man says single child psychology, so for this multiple children psychology, last child psychology, understanding human nature. Then so many 3 books I read. Then they are also disappointed. Then I took Jung, and Jung book also, introduction to Jung psychology, 1 or 2 books by Jung, and I have read that man going on talking about racial memories and all that. What he says is one of the very important thing. Suppose you are born with some genetic markers and some genes, you are from your father. Your grandfather, great-grandfather, great-grandfather and all that. Suppose that great-grandfather or his great-grandfather had a horrible fright of dying because he was enveloped with some fire and all that. That fire and the fear of death may be transmitted through the genes, and it may come to you. And sometimes when you see a picture or a scene, we may ignite that racial memory, that he calls it as racial memory, and you start having dreams of fire and all that. That is why, and I so thoroughly, he has so convincingly he discusses, then that is why one of the objection for me, my present colleagues, trying to interpret the dream with his life situation and all that. If the racial memory has been roused by some cause, you can't interpret the dream and all that. That's a different story. You will come to it afterwards when you have some doubt. Then we had this gestalt psychology by that gestalt psychology of fridge petals. He says that there in psychotherapy, he says, suppose, why I am not having sleep? He says, what do you think that cause of your insomnia? That a question is answered by another question, but the psychotherapist will never give an answer to the question of the patient. And in the book, he commits, this is like a homeopathy, similimum similibus curantur. A question is answered with question, and I allow the patient to think for himself because you can't understand the human being. So, all right. All these things are over. Then, while reading, nearly it took me some 1 year for going around all these things. All these books, a lot of money, and then a lot of strain to me, all these things. All these things are useless for homeopathy. You may use it to understand a person, but that is not useful to select the drug. Am I clear, sir, at this point? Now, at that time, what has happened? Accidentally, I caught hold of a book on Patterns of Growth in Personality by Gordon Allport. This Gordon Allport is supposed to be the most influential man in contemporary psychology next to Freud. His theory is every human being is like a moon. Darker side of the person, bright side of the personality. The darker side of the personality will not be known to any human being except to himself. The dark thoughts, then unsociable, unpardonable thinking and all that which may crop up. Nobody knows. He only knows. But on the brighter side, which is known to us, at least to some, and all of us know, every man has a personal face and a private face and a public. Admit, there is nothing wrong in it. Everybody is, will put on a mask when you come out of the sleep. And the wife also may not be knowing the face. Maybe she knows only the mask. All the time, whatever it is. Even that mask, if you want to understand, he says, every human being has got some traits, some habits, some enduring passions or enduring habits will be there. If you know some 10 traits of a person, you know that man. If you know 20, you know him more closely. If you know him 30, you know him more closely. And his theory is how these traits interact with one another and react to the situation itself is personality. You cannot understand beyond that of any man. I repeat again, sir. How these traits react with one another and how they react to a particular situation itself is personality. There is nothing beyond that which you can understand about any human being. This theory has attracted me a lot because all the traits are there in our repertory. And so I thought, if I know the repertory, the traits correctly, I can put it into this thing along with the physical generals, and then I can kind of get a constitutional remedy, both psychologically and physically, and that may be the answer for many of the problems which we are not able to treat in an indicated remedy. So constitutional remedy, to bring out the constitutional remedy, of course the physicals and physicals that are present when the patient is not suffering from any disease, we know it. But at the same time, psychologically also, how it is, what are the traits? If you combine these two, you will get the correct similimum, and correct drug for the particular constitution, and which fits the drug, will cure many diseases, almost all your diseases. That is why Goethe said, the nature has staked everything in individuality. It is not homeopathy now, it's individuality and all that. Long back Goethe said it. The nature staked everything in individuality. So if you want to know this particular individual, what he is, you must know the psychic path and the mental path. Something like desired sweets, doesn't like hot water bath. So like that in physical generals, you take, living alone the disease part. In the same way, living alone the disease part, your schizophrenia, or your manic depressive psychosis and all those things are superstructure developed on that. Before that, you must be able to decide what is the constitutional drug for that particular patient. That is what I was trying at, and I feel that is the reason where I got some very good results with homeopathic medicine, some fantastic results with homeopathic medicine because of this my concept of my understanding of this homeopathy like that. Then, put it just then.